June 23rd, 2015. An observation plane flies over the Atlantic coastline of Patagonia, Chile. 100,000 square miles of pristine wilderness. As it passes above a remote inlet, a camera captures a series of white anomalies on the shore below.
There are these large objects lying all across it. It's hard to tell exactly what they are.
When the crew flies lower, they discover a scene of true horror. Hundreds of whale corpses litter the secluded shoreline.
This is a lot of whales.
337. That's unthinkable.
This is an unprecedented biological catastrophe.
Experts are stunned. This is one of the largest mass whale deaths in recorded history.
Something very big had to have happened to affect this many whales at the same time.
Marine biologist Rob Nelson studies the footage to identify which species has died on these shores.
These are sei whales. You can tell because of the dark gray and the irregular white markings on them. They get over 50 feet in length.
Weighing in at up to 28 tons, equivalent to 4 African bull elephants, the sei whale is a true heavyweight of the seas. Nelson considers what type of predator could take down these colossal beasts.
There's only one marine mammal which will actively hunt and kill a large whale, and that's the orca or killer whale.
Orcas are only around a third of the size of sei whales, but their brains are much bigger.
When size is not on your side, then you have to strategize. They're like velociraptors in the ocean.
They'll target a mother whale with a newborn calf, and they will separate the child away from the mother whale. They're vicious.
In pods of up to 40 strong, orcas attack larger whales by taking turns ramming and biting their chosen victim. Then they launch from the water onto their prey, blocking their blowhole, weakening and exhausting them.
They are fantastic hunters. They basically work like a pack of wolves in the sea.
Yet when science journalist Haley Chamberlain studies the image, she contests the killer whale theory.
A pod of orcas working together, they can do big things. But the sheer number of whales that have been stranded here, that's really unlikely.
Investigators examine cases of other weird whale mass deaths and discover a common factor: war games.
There is no doubt that military operations can and do cause some strandings.
Nelson reveals that in July of 2011, British naval planes engaging in bombing practice over a small island in Cape Wrath, Scotland, missed their targets. 3 wayward 1,000-pound bombs splash down in the middle of the ocean and detonate on the seafloor.
You can only imagine what effect an explosion like that would have on an animal like a whale. Super sensitive, it's using sonar to listen and hear its environment. It'd be like getting hit in the head with a baseball bat.
Deafened and confused, 39 pilot whales beach themselves on the shore. The event has eerie parallels with the one in Patagonia.
We know along the southern coast of Chile, it's a great place to hide. Potentially covert operations could happen down there without anybody knowing.
With all of these whales that have been found dead on this beach, it's quite possible that it could be the result of underwater military testing.
When biologists reach the isolated coves to study the whales up close, they find no evidence of the internal damage associated with military testing. But stomach samples yield a clue. The presence of microorganisms known to cause a toxic algal bloom called red tide.
Toxic blooms take place when the conditions in the ocean are just right to allow particular species of algae to start proliferating.
Red tides typically form in summer, fueled by the sunlight they need to create energy.
The problem is, these algae produce toxins that can kill.
When shellfish feed on the algae, they accumulate deadly neurotoxins in their tissues, and a toxic time bomb enters the food chain.
The result is something called paralytic shellfish poisoning.
A single shellfish contaminated by red tide can be fatal to humans within 2 hours. Sei whales can consume around 2,000 pounds of these aquatic invertebrates every day. Investigators have found their giant killer.
Scientists call it cumulative toxicity. It means that if you ingest enough of something toxic, at a certain point, it will kill you. Even something as big as a whale can eat enough where eventually it will die.
In 2010, excavations unearthed the remains of 40 whales killed by the same toxin on the Chilean coast 9 million years ago. The red tide, it appears, is a serial killer throughout history.
What worries me is that red tide is not an isolated event. These mass deaths are going to keep happening.